Hey everyone, Matt out back here with another Destiny 2 strategy guide. In today's video, we're going to be knocking out the Cimmerian Garrison Ascendant Challenge. What we're going to do is pick up the bounty from Petrovenge and head over to the Chamber of Starlight over in Reyes Sylvia. Again, make sure that you pick up the bounty from Petrovenge and follow this path that you see here on screen so that you can get the Ascendant Challenge taken care of. As always, I've put timestamps on screen and in the description box below, as well as in the first pinned comment. If you have any other questions or you need some help, come on over to twitch.tv/manodestra777, where I help out people live inside of Destiny 2, from PvP to PvE to raids, exotic quest dungeons, and everything else in between. Come join the conversation and join in the stream. We'd love to have you join the community. Also, if you like this video, make sure you leave a positive comment, as well as subscribe and turn on notifications so that you don't miss any other videos that I make. As we come around the corner over here, we're going to find ourselves over in Reyes Sylvia, and we're going to be going over to this waterfall area here to the right as you enter in. Fall on down to this area and you will see the Lost Sector symbol right there on your screen. We're going to go ahead and go into this area and make our way to the Chamber of Starlight. As we head on into the area, a quick couple of reminders. You don't need to collect all the eggs or the bones that I'm putting in this video to complete the Ascendant Challenge. All you need to do is pick up the final chest at the end. That being said, also to see the Ascendant Challenge entrance, you must use a Tincture of Queen's Foil to see the secrets inside of the Dreaming City, most prominently the entrances to those Ascendant Challenges. So if you have questions on how to get a Tincture of Queen's Foil, check in the description box. I have a video just for you in case if you need to pick some up. As you make your way here through this cavern, go ahead and take out the enemies if you'd like, but if you don't, it's not a big deal. Just keep on moving. Make sure that you've popped your Tincture of Queen's Foil. You'll see on the left-hand side of my screen that there is a thing called Ascendance Blinking, so I know that I will be able to see all those secrets. And up above that area over there is the entrance to the Ascendant Challenge. Hop onto this rock here and then jump right on in, and you'll find yourself in Cimmerian Garrison. The Cimmerian Garrison is a giant obstacle course slash gauntlet that you are going to have to run through. Before we do that, we're going to pick up the first egg. If you are on the road that we start with, you are going to look off to the right hand side and you will see the egg very, very easily. Again, to collect the eggs, you must have the Wish Ender bow to collect them, so make sure that you have that bow on. When I say that this is an obstacle course, there are a number of different enemies that are trying to snipe you and kill you. There are a number of booping and knockoff mechanics. There are a number of shriekers throughout this. There are going to be knights later on. So basically the main thing you're going to want to do is just to keep pushing forward on the path that you see here on screen. If you stand your ground and kill a bunch of enemies, that's not the end of the world, but there are constantly knights that are going to be chasing you. So the important thing you're going to want to do is keep moving forward against these enemies that you're going to see. Those knights can kill you if you get stuck anywhere, but what I'm going to do here is I'm going to knock out all of these enemies so that I can take out the second egg. We're going to pull out our Wishender bow here in just a second, and off in the distance on the left hand side, you're going to see the final area where we're going to end up at the end of this, but right behind that area is the second egg location. You can also pick it off on this area, on this platform here. That's a little bit of an easier area, but you can also pick it up at the end of the Ascendant Challenge when you get the boss killed as well. So take your choice and go ahead and take care of that. Fun fact, if you are someone who's trying to kill a bunch of knights and things like that, if you've got the bounty from the Dreaming City, the random bounty that makes it so you have to kill knights, this area right here is a great place to do it. Right here in this spot, the knights will not proceed any farther forward. I can sit here and continue to do damage to them and they cannot do anything. So if you need to kill some Abyssal Champions, you can do that right here. They'll push forward, but as soon as you get onto the white area, they can't do anything. Even if you do kill the knights, however, they will respawn throughout the Ascendant Challenge. So only do this if you need to get the bounty completion. So we're going to start running on the path again, and as soon as I get down the road just a certain amount, you'll see the knights spawn behind you. And it will say the knights close in on the left-hand side of your screen. So just keep on moving. Again, there's going to be some knockoff mechanics, as well as some different enemies that are going to be chasing you. Once you get to the end of this road, it's going to take you down onto a platform right here where there's going to be some taken phalanxes. Throwing a grenade at them is a really good choice. When you hop up here, the knights are not going to be behind you anymore. They are going to be in front of you and they are going to be able to run at you quickly. So you're going to want to jump through there as quick as you can. Now, normally you take a right and keep on moving, but we are going to show you where the bones location is. You can stand over here and be very, very safe at the end of this road platform here. There's going to be some bones right here at the very edge of this structure. In addition, this is also a great place to get your third egg right there. You can see it off in the distance right underneath the main platform that you're going to be heading to. So that's all the secrets that you need to finish this Ascendant Challenge. Now, as soon as you are ready to knock this out, go ahead and change to whatever weapons will be really good for the final boss. The final boss is a giant Taken Knight that, again, is trying to knock you off the edge and kill you. So what you want to do is be able to do as much burst damage to him as possible while staying safe. I'm going to go ahead and make my way up this spiral staircase here, and as soon as that happens, some of these Taken defense mechanisms will start to pop up here. Also, the knockoff mechanics will also start spawning in, so be aware that as you see them start to charge, give them a second and keep moving. The knights will also start chasing you, as will some Taken Thrall. The big thing about this is to not get frazzled. Take your time. Don't rush through. Just keep moving. Through here, there's a number of Taken Booping Cannons. Just jump right over it and keep moving forward. 9 times out of 10, you'll be able to just go right through there and continue on your way up the staircase. Now, as soon as you get up to the top of the staircase, some more knights are actually going to spawn in, but just keep moving. As we get to this platform over here, we're going to see Toland, and Toland is going to beckon us over to the final area. Just like some other Ascendant challenges, there's going to be some rotating platforms and some non-rotating platforms. Take a second, get your bearings, and make sure that you can knock out these two defense mechanisms here that are going to shoot you. As soon as we get those guys knocked out, keep moving. You can see that the rocks are rotating, and sometimes you might have to move from rock to rock to rock. Any kind of a jumping exotic or a mobility exotic would be very helpful here, but you can easily tell the rotating rocks from the non-rotating rocks. The non-rotating rocks have a very kind of earthy feel to them. The other ones are very blue. They look very, very animated in a different way. Once you see it in the game, it's very clear to see. So once you get to this final platform here, this is the final area where you're going to be. So you need to kill that knight without getting knocked off. However, if you jump up too high off the ground, there is a shrieker that will appear and try and knock you off. So in other words, you can't stand on top of these rocks and try to do some damage. Shotguns are really good for this. Grenade launchers are okay as long as you don't absolutely annihilate yourself while you're doing this. I'd recommend using an Ikelos or any kind of a Vorpal weapon shotgun when you're doing this, and make sure that as soon as you start to see him swinging for it, that you take a second and you go ahead and get as much damage as you can, move, reload, and go from there. I'm using Thunderlord here, which was a more common exotic back in year 2, but there are lots of different choices right now that you could probably get that would be good choices. Maybe you want to use Witherhorde right now. That'd be a pretty good choice. There's a lot of different weapons that you could use to knock out this boss without doing too much damage. Now, if you try to kill those Shriekers, they are going to automatically respawn. So just make sure you take out the knight as soon as possible. Once he gets down to a certain amount of health, his helmet will come off, so you're going to want to completely finish him when you get to that point. One more reminder that you do need to pick up the chest to actually complete the Ascendant Challenge bounty. From that point, you can hop right on out back into the Chamber of Starlight. If you have any other questions or you want to join in on the conversation or get more helps, come on over to twitch.tv/manodestra777. Join the conversation, join the community. We'd love to have you there. Again, we'd like to have you in our Discord as well. Our Discord is full of lots of people who enjoy playing Destiny 2, and it's also a great place to meet folks to game with. As always, if you have not subscribed to the channel, make sure you do that and turn on notifications so you don't miss any of my Destiny 2 content. Good hunting, Guardians. I'll see you next time in the universe of Destiny.